Got ink? Head to audioinkradio.com and find exclusive artist interviews, Q&As, photos, contests, music news, and more. Whew, that's a lot of ink. It's audioinkradio.com.
Welcome to the Audio Ink Radio podcast, featuring interviews with the biggest names in rock and metal, hosted by Ann Erickson.
Hi, everyone. This is Mark Cimani from Cimani, the Audio Ink Radio with Ann Erickson.
What's up, guys? It's Ann Erickson. As always, thanks so much for being here on the podcast. I have a really awesome guest today. You know him and love him from Alter Bridge and Creed. It's the one and only Mark Tremonti. So it's really exciting that you've got another Tremonti record, A Dying Machine, and it's a concept record, which is really cool. So how did that come about?
Well, I was on tour last year, and I started playing around with title track, A Dying Machine. That was kind of the key that planted the whole concept. That was, you know, that song kind of came together conceptually, and I didn't want to leave the mood of that. Never something on my radar whatsoever. I never really dug into concept records too much, other than just a couple that I had in my collection, but it wasn't something that I thought about doing.
Are there any concept records that are maybe your all-time favorite albums? A band like Pink Floyd, for example, is really known for that sort of thing.
No, it was never really something that I was a big fan of. You know, if it was a concept record, I didn't even really put two and two together half the time. You know, it was just kind of, there were just records. I never really sat down and listened to a song and listened to the concept from start to finish. So it was, like I said, it just kind of fell in my lap. It was never really so much on my radar.
Cool. Well, tell me a little about the story behind the concept of A Dying Machine and what inspired it.
Well, when I was writing the title track, I was sitting down and I came up with, I just spit out lyrics sometimes, and I spit out "You're a Dying Machine," and then wrote another point of view in the song. So it's a conversation between a man and a created being that was created to love him, and that's all she knew. So in the end, she was obsessed about him and ends up killing him in the end out of passion. So I thought the concept could be, it takes place at the turn of the next century. It created the first synthetic human brain. So, I mean, along the way, we've created synthetic hearts and livers and all these things. So we become more machine as time goes on, and finally we create the synthetic brain. And you can create beings exactly how you want them to be. You create a servant or a lover or a security, military, whatever. And the story pretty much is how we create these people in our own image.
And what makes you most excited about taking these new songs on the road?
I think it's just our best record. You know, it's my favorite so far, by far. I know live they're going to be a lot of fun to play, and so far, so I'm sure when the record comes out, I hope people feel the same way about the rest of the record.
And tell me about the novel that you have that'll be with the record.
Working around the clock, trying to finish it, hopefully this, but it's my first time doing something like this, so I didn't know the business in and out. So once I finish the first manuscript here and turn it in, it's going to go, have to go through copy editing, maybe 3 weeks, and then it's going to probably take 6 to 8 weeks once I get it finished to get it printed and ready to ship.
I was wondering, you're known obviously for your fantastic guitar work. If you had to name your top five favorite guitarists of all time, who would they be?
I'd say Stevie Ray Vaughan, Jeff Beck, Derek Trucks, Matias Asato, and right now maybe Sean Tubbs.
It's cool to see how you've become a lead vocalist in Tremonti. So do you find yourself kind of more comfortable with that as time goes on? It seems like you were pretty comfortable with it even at first, but from the newer songs I'm hearing, I can just tell you seem like more, I don't know, more comfortable or something.
Yeah, I mean, when you do the first record, it was kind of, I was a little nervous to do it for the first time. You know, I've been a songwriter since I was a little kid, and I always thought that my voice wasn't strong enough to make my ideas meet their full potential, so I always put it on somebody else. And finally, you know, taking that first step, when it's something you've put on the back burner your whole life, it was kind of nerve wracking. But once you get past that first step, like I said, you just get more confidence, and now I don't second guess myself.
Awesome. And I have to ask, Alter Bridge, any plans right now for new stuff from them down the road?
Well, we recorded a couple of our shows over in Europe at the Royal Albert Hall with orchestra, symphony. So we're recording we're putting out a DVD of that later on this year.
Cool. What about like a new album, back in the studio, anything like that maybe next year?
Yeah, it'll probably come out late next year. We'll probably record it sometime in the early summer, and then I'm going to go back on tour with Jermaine hopefully next summer. Then following that, we'll do the album release, and really looking forward to releasing the record and the novel.
Well, thank you again so much, Mark. A Dying Machine from Tremonti out June 8th. Make sure to pick it up.
It's the cutting edge of new music and the forefront of rock. It's Audio Inc. with Anne.
Thanks for listening to another episode of the Audio Inc. Radio Podcast. Subscribe to our channel so you never miss an episode. Get inked online at audioincradio.com. I'm Anne Erickson for the Audio Inc. Radio Podcast.